Hi everyone, my name is Dara. I'm from the Khmer lesson. Okay, welcome back to learn Cambodian with me again. Okay, so as I promised you before that I will make a video of Khmer traditional game. Okay, so now today in this lesson I will show you 10 Khmer traditional game in Cambodia. And actually not only 10 Khmer traditional game, but also we have more than this. But in this video I will show you only 10 okay Khmer traditional games. Okay, so if you are ready, let's get started with me together. Lập bán pro pay ni khmer. Lập bán pro pay ni khmer. Khmer traditional games. Lập bán đặt chọn. Or lập bán yêu. Okay, so in English you will say đặt chọn game or king game. Okay, và so đặt it mean king and chọn it mean want. So for the name of this game we say lập bánh đặt chọn rứ lập bánh yêu. Okay, lập bánh yêu. Okay, so I will read in English for you. Okay, đặt chọn or king game is a game that boys, girls or teenagers from every village all over Cambodia always play during their free time at night time under the moonlight. Players have too many male and female players, which are unlimited. When playing, they are divided into two groups, one male and one female. In both groups, they set up a male or a female as a king to sit in the center. The playing activities as follows. While the king was sitting on a suitable place, a female side let a girl walk to whisper to the king that she loves this name of male side. For example, name A or name B. After whisper, she turns back to her own spot. The male side also let one man go to the king. If the man who came and didn't match with the name of the previous whisper or female, it was nothing happened. But if that man came in the name of girl whispering, the king shout in sound ew, ew, and let that girl riding on the back of the boy, then walk to the boy's side. Then the man's side lets a man whisper, and if he whispers that he loves a girl named A and goes back to his spot. If a girl named A comes in, the king shout in sound ew, ew, and let the boy ride on the woman with screaming the same ew, ew. So it means that if each side comes to whisper that they love the man or woman named A and name B turns to the king will not let the whisper ride on and tell the whisper to turn back his spot, and he will turn aside to whisper. And they keep doing this way until night. The king is to judge the matter with the truth and justice. This game depends on the king's way. If the king has bias mind and wants anyone to write on beside the name that was a whisper. For example, if a person comes to whisper name A and name B to walk in, the king could shoot ew, ew, due to the last one have heard the previous one whisper to love any names. But if there is such a way of playing, players can protest and ask them to change the king if the king plays without truth and justice. This game is not only a fun game, but also a game that trains people to be honest and justice, not to be rational, in four different ways such prejudice because of love or desire, prejudice because of hate or enmity, prejudice because of fear, prejudice because of dilution or stupidity. In addition, training people to be able to choose someone to be their representative, whom they think is a good person, right person, and a person that works well in a true way. Okay, so for game number two, the name is Lập bánh lẹ cẩn sành. Lập bánh lẹ cẩn sành. Okay, so in English you will say lẹ cẩn sành game. So if you break the word lẹ, it means to hide. And cẩn sành, it means towel or handkerchief. Okay, and also you can use croma, okay, for this game as well. Okay. Okay, so now I will read, okay, about this game for you. Lẹ cẩn sành means hiding towel or Cambodia croma. Before starting playing, the cẩn sành or croma must be twisted in together in a small shape. This kind of game is playing by gathering 10 to 20 people sit in circle. Then, it has to be one person who stays out of the group for using the consign to hide behind someone who sits in the group. Thus, once someone realizes there is a consign behind them, they have to hit someone left consign or known as the hider while he or she finding place to sit. The special thing about this game is that it has a very beautiful lyric and rhythm of hider to sing while finding someone to left the consign behind them. Okay, game number three. Lập bánh cháo chung. Lập bánh cháo chung. Okay, in English you say cháo chung game. Cháo chung game. Okay, so chung represents of small object which is soft for throwing. Therefore, everyone finds it convenient to catch. This sort of game is playing following the steps of dividing people into two groups, and each group must have 10 to 20 males, and the other group must have 10 to 20 females. The group who has the duty of throwing chung has to sing and dance while throwing, and the other group has to catch and throw back while singing and dancing too. If one of member fails to catch the chung, he or she has to perform some of comedy. Number 4. Lập bánh tiên prot. Lập bánh tiên prot. Okay, so for this game in English, you will say tagging rituals and games. Okay. Tagging rituals and games in the rice farming cultures of East Asia and Southeast Asia are enacted among communities to ensure abundant harvest and prosperity. They promote social solidarity, provide entertainment, and mark the start of a new agricultural cycle. Many tagging rituals and games also have profound religious significance. Tagging rituals and games is a fun game of Cambodian youth, both men and women. This game is played with physical force, and it is played only in the Khmer New Year. They play in the pagoda during Khmer New Year because of the extensive field in the pagoda, but they can still play in the villages if there are many people gathered with enough space for playing. The game is often played in the daytime, but if there is a bright lamp or moonlight, it can be played at night. The composition of gamers is divided into two groups on each side by at least 5 to 10 people. But in local tradition, if there are numerous women play, they will have divided into women's side and men's side. Normally, they knew that women are less power than men. Therefore, they will put more people in the women's side with at least 2 people. For example, if men's side are 8 people, women's side will be 10 people. First, They choose one man and one woman with extraordinary strength to stand at the end of each side. And others, men and women with strong bodies, stand in the middle of the rope, and other respective people with a small body, thin, fanned, stand in the space between the middle and the end of the rope. And when it was prepared, the man who hold the gong or some pole stand upright near the two stood face to face, starting to shout out loud as yeah-oh with deep voice. Okay, so I stop a bit. So for the word gong or some pole is the name of Khmer musical instrument that we call gong or some pole. Okay, now I start to continue. And all the gamers were shouting at each other that Ho Wei. Yeah, Ho Wei. They shout this word for three times. Then they tug for their own victory and stop until they have found the winner or loser. In each game, they spend 5 to 10 minutes to see the winner or loser for each side. When they found the winner and the loser, they will start again until they end up with the drawing of each side. They consider this game as fitness exercise and also serve to strengthen unity and solidarity and a sense of belonging and identity among community members. Number 5. Lập bán chắp con khlành. Lập bán chắp con khlành. Okay, in English you say chắp con khlành game. Okay, for this game is mainly played by adults on the first New Year's Day or the night of the first New Year's Day. A player with the strongest body structure imitates a hen protecting her chicks from another player imitating a crow, while the other players hide behind the hen as chicks. The crow tries to catch as many chicks as possible. Number 6. Là bán ao trò lạc rứ bé ở lạc. Là bán ao trò lạc rứ bé ở lạc. Okay, it means ao trò lạc or bé ở lạc game. Okay. And also we have another name for this game that we say pick fruits game. But pick fruits game. Okay, so if you break the word from the name of this, out, it means to hug. Nah? Out. Trolak is winter melon. Okay, so out trolak, it means you hug a winter melon. Okay, and another one, we use another fruit instead that we say alak. Alak. But we say bèh ở lạc. So bèh with fruit, it means to pick. To pick. And ở lạc, it means watermelon. Okay. So the name of this game, it means you can say hug wintermelon or pick watermelon. Okay. But. Okay, so now I read for you. There are many types of Khmer games. Some games are played only on the daytime or night time. Some are played during Khmer Lunar New Year. And some games are played indefinitely. Games that usually play only during the night time with moonlight and no need to have any festivals such as Ao Tro Lai or Bèh Ở Lạc, etc. This game is a fun game for girls and boys in every rural country in Cambodia. How to play? Firstly, boys and girls reconcile and gather many people, and then they set a person to be Trolak or Alak, another to be the buyer, and the rest to be Trolak or Alak as well. All the player has to find a tree trunk or store with the right size. When it is a convenient, the first kit among other kits that play a role as melon or watermelon to sit in the front and hug the stall and following by other kits. One child play role as the owner or seller of the melon or watermelon. He or she will stand nearby his or her melon. And watermelon and other kid who is a buyer will come to bargain with him or her. After they agree on their bargaining, the buyer is allowed to harvest the melon. Then, the buyer came to knock on the back of kid who sit in line. While knocking, the buyer was also asking that kchai or tum. It means unripe or ripe. Okay. The buyer asked from the beginning with an answer unripe until the ending with an answer ripe. Then he pulled out the last one with a strong effort and the seed players keep hug each other in tightening. The buyer collected one by one until the last, and if he could not collect due to his weaker than others, they start the game again. And the seller and buyer will change to be seed player, and seed players will become a seller and buyer. They do so until they quit. This game is an ancient Gekmai game for exercise, the body, especially arm and leg muscle, to be strong with good health. Number 7. Lập bánh crop mòn. Lập bánh crop mòn. Okay, it's crop mòn game or chicken hiding game. Okay, so crop mòn game is an entertaining game for teenagers, both male and female from all over Cambodia. Often play in the free time at night. Players consist of male and female, about 8 to 10 people on each side. For playing the game, they will choose one male and one female from both sides, covering from them by skirt, scarf, or blanket from hair to toe. But do not let them know who they are and let the two face each other. Men represent a male chick and women represent a female chick. After covering, they will let the male side knock on the back of female chick, and female chick have to shout on in sound kikai kaket with trying to make a distinctive voice. But if the two did not hear enough, they could knock three times. Then the male player listened to the voice of the female chick, and they guessed the name of the woman they knew. After answering the name, they opened the lid, and if it was right, they will keep the female chick at their side. Then the female side knocks on the male chick once, and the male chick acts the same thing as the female does. The women listen to the voice of the male chick, and they were guessed by the names of the known men if the female predicted right. They take the female chick which they have taken, and if they predicted wrong, the male side will take away another one from the female side. If you have the more right prediction, you will get more chicks and vice versa. They do this until one side lose all their chicks or one side that have more chicks in their side. They consider as a winner and start to play again. They always do this until they want to stop. This game is a fun game for teenagers and also train the human mind, thinking, and listening skill. Number 8. Lập bánh bật buồn. Lập bánh bật buồn. Okay, bật buồn game. Okay. So, but buồn is a game where young boys and girls always play on the night of the dawn. This game is played indefinitely in any season or month, as long as there is leisure time and no limit to the number of people. The measure of this game consists of the one who hide the others and the searcher. When the searcher catching the high players and rounded their ears. How to play? Firstly, they are gathered up boys and girls in the same age, about 5 to 10 people up. Then they divide it into two equal parts, one female or one male or mixed up. They have defined a place called T and hide somewhere else without let the searcher's sight find them. While the searcher's sight was standing with eye closed or sealed. The norm of this game is the eye closed, which they promise that whoever intends to see where the hider is hidden, and they will be blind. Soi pnek. Then they choose someone who a bit taller for waiting and protecting the place by not letting the hiders come in. And the leftovers are looking for the hide players in every conceivable place. If any of the searchers see the hiders, they will chase after them and round ears. If they can catch the hiders, they call over. And if the hider comes into the spot, they are free from rounded ears. While the hider arrives on the spot, they have to shout out, "I'm in." If not shouting, the searchers will chase them and rounded their ears again. When the searchers find all the hidden a few of them, they will change their position searchers to hider and vice versa. This game can be referred to as exercising on the running and jumping. Number 9. Lập bán bóh ẩn cung. Lập bán bóh ẩn cung. Okay, it's bóh ẩn cung game. Bóh ẩn cung game. Ankun is a type of fruit in Cambodia which is really firm, and they don't eat them not only because of its strong color, but also because of its tasteless. Therefore, what is the benefit of it? The good thing about Ankun is that Khmer people use it for playing game which is called Boh Ankun. It means throwing this fruit. In addition, there are some rules that require players to follow. First, you have to separate players into two groups, and each group have 3 to 5 members. Then, if the first player has to throw their ankun to other groups of ankun in front of them. For group who wins, they have to use the same ankun to hit group who lose on the knees to each person. Number 10. Lập bán vây om. Lập bán vây om. That in English you say breaking clay pot. Okay, breaking clay pot. Okay, one of the most popular games during the Cambodian New Year holidays. Thin clay pot with flower and a small prize are hung on a rope between trees. The aim of the game is to smash one of the pot with a stick while blindfolded. The player follow the direction of the screaming crowd and try to find the right position to hit the pot. If the player hits the pot, there is first a flower shower while the others already collect the sweet from the ground. Okay, that's all for this lesson, and thanks for watching. I hope everyone enjoyed this lesson, and also I hope this lesson is useful for foreigners who would like to know about Cambodian culture or about my traditional games. Okay, so if someone still not clear or have any question related to this lesson, just let me know by leaving your comment below, and I will come to you in the next video. Stay safe and have a great day. And at the end, I will not forget to say, Susanay Chnam Thmay.